This is the Rumor Report with Angela Yee. Rumor has it. On the Breakfast Club.
So listen up.
All right, well, Tyler Perry has joined the Hurricane Harvey Club as far as donating money, but he donated $1 million. All right, so we told you before, Donald Trump is pledging $1 million, and now Tyler Perry has done it. Ellen DeGeneres, Walmart donated $1 million. She donated that on her show. Now, here's what he had to say about where he is giving this money.
Joel and Victoria are amazing people. There's no way that they would lock people out of the church or not let people in for a shelter. There were some safety concerns. I spoke to them on the phone, and it all made perfect sense to me. So at this $1 million, I'm breaking it up into quarters. I'm sending $250,000 to Lakewood. And also, I'm working with Beyonce's pastor, Rudy Rasmus, to give another $250,000. And I'm saving $500,000 for other charities right now. I'm not quite sure exactly which ones they use or go to.
Drop on the clues bonds with Tyler Perry. I appreciate that. You know, he's also opening his home to any young men who may need a place to stay.
You stop it.
Come on, man.
You stop it.
Now, J.J. Watt has already raised more than $13 million for Hurricane Harvey.
J.J. Watt will have to start his own foundation. You can't just be raising that kind of money and not have a place to put it.
You Caring fundraiser.
Oh, okay.
Is what he is doing.
Gotcha.
Now, Drake just donated toward that foundation as well. Here's what Drake said.
My good friend J.J. Watt has started a fundraising effort through You Caring, and I've donated $200,000 towards it. I'll be leaving the link in my bio. The journey to rebuilding is going to be a long one, so anything you can give is greatly appreciated.
I respect everybody that's giving money to organizations that are going to directly impact the people. Salute to my guy, Trader Truth. That's who I'm giving, you know, my money and resources to. Him and the Angel by Nature and Friends Know Houston and Golden Triangle. They are raising money for Port Arthur in Houston. And you can call 832-250-3565 for more details on that.
Okay.
All right. Now, according to J.J. Watt, he said, my first phase is what I'm doing is this weekend. My teammates and I have semi-trucks rolling in from out of town that we filled up. We have about 9 semi-trucks that are going to come to town, and that's all filled with stock, supplies, water, food, clothing, everything. So that's their first step, just starting this weekend. And he's also having a collection drive in Wisconsin, where he lives, for victims of the flooding. They're asking for donations of blankets, non-perishable items. And then he said he's going to regroup and devise a new plan for the millions he has raised and seek advice from individuals and organizations that help victims of Katrina.
That's dope.
All right, now Chuck D and Flavor Flav had some back and forth. Now, apparently, Flavor Flav has a lawsuit. He's suing Chuck D and Public Enemy producers, saying they cut him off from royalties, merchandising, and performance fees.
I seen Flavor Flav last weekend, too.
Oh, you did? Where? In Vegas?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, Chuck D said, we will be together on a future stage, and he also thinks that Flavor Flav will again be embarrassed admitting on stage about the way it spun out. It's always this way with him. He said he's ready and willing to address Flavor Flav's concerns in the future, but right now he hopes his partner will be woke in the rehearsal studio and paying attention to the work we and all the members do worldwide.
What is Flavor hoping to get, though?
I guess he feels like he's owed some money. He didn't get certain royalties, merchandising money, so do that audit and see. Now, Flavor Flav said, attention, everyone. This is Flavor Flav speaking himself. I love my partner, Chuck D. Everyone, so don't get it twisted. We will fix it. And he wants you to know it's nothing like that. So that's good to know. At least they can perhaps resolve
But he just realizing in 2017, I mean, I don't know if he's not receiving royalties or not, but if he's not, he's just realizing he's not, hasn't received royalties in 2017. Like, when's the last time Public Enemy put out an album?
Well, I don't know, but according to Chuck D, it's a third-party merchandiser, and just the way the business works now, so it's probably something more current.
Oh, so they probably mean like those, like you see, like the Public Enemy, like
hats, t-shirts,
action figures,
right.
And, I think I've seen clocks and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, so he probably feels like, I need to get my just due. All right, Remy Ma and Cardi B, are they going to work on some music together? Of course, they're both from the Bronx, right? Well, here is what Remy had to say during a VH1 Facebook Live.
Oh, we actually were talking about it last night.
I hope so.
She like literally grabbed me. She was like, we need to do a song together. I was like, okay. She's like, I'm not playing. I'm serious. I'm like, you got my number.
Now, I'm here for that.
Remy Ma had admitted, she said, you know, when she first heard it in this business, you see people come in and take this thing as a joke, this rap thing. And then she said, I saw one day she was 17 in high school. She was performing in a talent show and it just changed everything. I think she works really hard and she deserves it.
Two of my favorite personalities on the planet. Drop on the clues bombs for Cardi B and Remy Ma. Cardi B got the #2 song in the country, #1 rap record, and Bodak Yellow just went gold.
Yep, congratulations to Cardi B.
Yes.
All right. Well, I'm Angela Yee, and that is your rumor report.
It's now a good time to remind DJ Self that he used to run with Cardi B, that he introduced her. But now's not a good time.
I'm sure he knows.
I'm just making sure.
He knows.
But he's got Mariah Lynn on deck. Oh, she's going to be big.
No, he got Lou Got Cash. Lou Got Cash.
I'm BS'ing. I was playing. I was being sarcastic.
I know you are.
Okay. Just want to throw that out there.
All right, sarcastic, man.
I got to stop being me.
Yes.
Yeah, that's Self is your friend.
I didn't have to say that. I didn't even have to
that's
say
your
that.
Friend. It's unnecessary.
We'll just throw your buns around.